Give someone an option today, but before I do that, I gotta go feed my animals. First things first, my name is Kenneth Bird. My company is Crystal Edge Technology Screens, and we are the developers of Blue, the AR-15, AR-17, and Supreme. Yeah, you heard me say AR-17. Yep, I gotta go feed my animals. I'll be back.
I gotta wash dishes today too. Sweep off the hairy sweep in there so real quick.
We start a process for AR-17 coming soon. It's going to have sun killer technology embedded in it. So wipe everything out in one hit. Over the next stage, dropping that sun killer coat. Then we'll go up to Black Diamond. They're all going down.
Every last one of them going to crash and burn.
Yes. Alright, I need a broom.
Just had a few minutes
away. Oh, here's the back. 17 with the freaking so 17. Go back in. Let's go feed my stray animals real quick. I'll be back. Let's feed my stray animals. We switched over projectors. We're down to 4300 lumen Christi. I want to take my sneakers off. I'm going to be outside in the floor. I want to try to be nice here. I'm going to give Mr. Fernando Gonzalez a chance. I'm still going to sue you. That's definitely going to happen. Nothing's going to change about that. But you mind your own business, you stay in your lane, and I won't have to do any more demonstrations against you against this technology. You want to go down that road? Within a month's time, I'll obsolete everything you have. You have my word on that. So it's up to you. How you want to do it? I can do tests against your technology against this screen, and it will easily be able to dominate anything you design. You mind your own business. You develop your own technology, you stay in your own lane, and you mind your business. Don't do any more reviews about our technology, nothing. You do something again, then basically I'll show you what the screen can do at 50% to 100%. It's only at 2% done. So, like I said, I couldn't care less about you trying to do demonstrations against our Blue. Our investors are laughing at that one right there because you don't put your screens in any form of ambient light. And anything that Blue can stand into. So I know for a fact that everything you're doing at level is fake. But I gave you an option. As for the challenges, they still stand. Other than that, if you want to go toe-to-toe with this technology, be my guest. We'll buy every last one of your products. We'll have them over here. We'll do them all in one hit. We'll do the demonstration. I'll do the screen at maybe 20%. So giving you the option to mind your own business. Like I said, I don't have a problem with people doing side-by-side demonstrations, but when you want to delivery, disrupt our product by basically sticking in black paint and making our product seem darker than what it is and calling us scammers and all that nonsense, yeah, then you took it too far. So, like I said, this is why I developed this technology, to pretty much wipe out what you have. So, like I said, mind your own business, and the test with your stuff laying against the screen will end. There's your option right there. You continue on, I'll buy every last one of your products, as I said before, and I'll put it at a 17. See, as I said before, you don't see everything we bring out, and we do have a 17. You're one. Take it or leave it, it's up to you. Starting next month, I'll start beginning the process of licensing my stuff out, basically getting it ready for manufacturing. I think we're going to do contracts again. Might as well.
Thank you.
saying. My people sit there and say I don't take care of my customers. My customer's lens got busted and broken his projector. And I went out and bought him a brand new one out of my own pocket to make sure so he can run our product off his projection screen. See, I take care of my customers. So he bought a 505 upstairs and couldn't get the screen to focus right. I sold him the projector. The lens was busted. So I went out of my own pocket. I bought one. I actually sent the one I had upstairs. It got lost in shipping. So I went back on eBay and bought another one for him to send to him so he can have his setup set up. That's how far I got on my way to take care of my customers. Make sure that they got everything they need to get set up. Gotta send that one off today. Deal with any other company, and they're not gonna do that for you. You out of pocket, you out of pocket. That's how it's gonna be. Not with my customers. I'm tracking his tracking information. The new one that I sent to him actually went out of my projector, got delivered. So he did get it. So now I got an extra one sitting around, which is interesting because now I just put that back in the other one that I had already. Or I just got an extra lens for if my Chrissy has a problem, which it shouldn't. I don't know why I would have the damaged one, but if I happen to drop it or break it, I got another one back up for it. Just make sure my customers have what they need. My area, get it back to normal because I can't stay in front of it, I can't stay in mess. Excuse me. So he's got an ultimatum. It's up to him whether or not if he takes it or not. Mind his own business, stay in his lane, but if he doesn't, then I'll bring out a 17. So who's gonna sit there and say, oh, but it doesn't exist? Yeah, but you didn't know we can develop great screens, did you? There's one right there, or blue. Not even existed. I need to put this someplace.
Put it someplace where it has to go.
You want to review people's stuff, but you don't want them reviewing your stuff. You want to start canceling orders out. Screening people because you're free and stop doing demonstrations on the gap.
Good stuff, and you're right by the house of the phone. I was supposed to downstairs, Josh. Downstairs.
Before you start thinking like, oh, he must be doing this because of the blue. Dude, you couldn't come close to blue if your life depended on it. The ambient light that thing takes in, you can't even put your own screen paint in that kind of ambient light without a washing out. So I know you don't have that skill capability to do that. But I gave you your ultimatum. You continue to do demonstrations, false demonstrations. I don't mind you doing demonstrations against the product. When you do that false nonsense, that I don't like. If you can't do fair demonstrations, you don't want people doing demonstrations against your stuff, then don't even bother that field. Cut that out altogether. Just stick to what you know, stay in your lane. If not, when you continue on that road, I will make sure I will get every last one of your screen paints down here, and I'll put them against a 17. You'll see stuff that you've never even seen designed before. Like I said, we only allow you to see what we allow you to see. You're watching screen paints being developed in 2 hours. So if we spend a little time on something basic to seriously wipe everything out, we could do it, no problem. I'm giving you a chance to go about your business. But like I said, you continue on, I'll bring up a 17, we'll buy all your products, and we'll wipe it out outside. Or I'll put you against a sun killer. Either way, you'll be obsolete. So you got an option. Run with it. Run your business and run with it. But don't get me wrong when I say this. I'm still going to sue you, so you know that. There's nothing going to stop that one. So you know that. You're still going to get sued. Shouldn't have touched my copyright to begin with. That was a bad idea. But other than that, doing any more tests against your stuff, you want that to stop? Mind your own business, stay in your own field. You keep doing these dirty demonstrations against me and other people, then I'm going to continue on this path with this, and we'll bring a 17 out, and we'll wipe everything you have. Because this is already doing it at 2%.
No time to think about your little petty paints.
We have a great cinema by Leap Screens. Maybe 1.3 and a great sim of 5D. We have to test those.
We'll have to test it. Let me get all these lined up. We have all lined up. All right, so we got the cinema gray. That's the cinema gray. Right there. Cinema gray. There. Upstairs somewhere. I'm going to go upstairs and find it. Thank you.
cyber skunk. Game stunk. That's the worst thing I ever played. $60 down the drain. Okay, what do we got here? Selection here. See my AV 1.3.
Next. Parallax,
Yeah, I think I've seen that correctly. Let's see how this measures up. Shoot this one. Sample. Here we go. One of the test demonstrations we have to do is we have to test it against everything. And what I mean by, if anyone's going to call themselves Make It Our Product, they will have to test it against every screen that we place against that screen. So that's why I said it's not that easy. So if they make the product correctly, they will be able to beat those screens or even match some of those screens with no problem. Just because it's blue doesn't make it our technology. Oh, and keep in mind, as we explained before, the reason why the screen has the coating blue on it was to show off the screen's coating capability of being able to change colors and read the projector. The blue surface has nothing to do with the product. I hope he knows that, right? Because we had that coating purple too. That was a gray Cinema 5D, which I should have showed you before I put it over there. Sorry about that. He thinks because he makes it blue, that's what makes it blue. No, it's a coating that makes it blue. There you go. It's a coating that gives it the ability to do so. The screen is just displaying what it does. It has 100% coating. It doesn't make a difference if the screen is blue. That does not make the screen. It's the coating inside that makes the screen. All right, we'll let them run. See how that goes on that test. Something. This is where he makes some stuff up. And I hate to call him an idiot, but that's kind of what he's becoming right now. See, when we developed the code, We had the coat and a bit of everything. We had it in the black. We had it in the silver, black, silver. It had a little bit of it. Blue is the only one that has 100% coat in it. So trying to convince people that we have a code embedded into a screen that allows the projector to be the recolor, we made two versions of this technology. We made a blue and we made a purple. So if you go and you type in purple projection screen, ours pops up. Because to show off that the screen has the ability to read code, the surface has nothing to do with it, not even the color blue. It's the coding within the screen that gives it the ability to do so. And this is where he's making himself look like a complete idiot, because he thinks if he makes the screen blue, that is the technology. No, it's the coding in the screen. First test results. But we'll make some more of it. And we'll actually paint a screen using purple. Must be doing purple. Oh, I did 100, and I remember I did the 192-inch fixed range screen was coated in purple. There you go, purple. A purple projection screen that has 100% of that code in it. So we were able to take a purple surface, and even though it had the code in it, that's what makes the screens do what they do. It's not the color, it's a code. That's why if you look at black silvers come up looking dark, like a black screen, because they can read a high contrast, where this technology, on the other hand, we developed over here, has an extremely high white level for a screen that is a dark gray, a bit of a dark gray. So knock yourself out. He's completely in disarranged on it. Like I said, we gave you your ultimatum. You don't take it, like I said, within a month's time, I will have enough videos broadcasted on your stuff on every test, on every demonstration versus a 17. And you think that stuff is a nightmare. That stuff we got down in the basement in that little glass container is definitely a nightmare. There you go, painting a purple screen. So you can see that it's an actual purple screen. So Crow, what you're doing over there is making yourself look like an idiot. My sisters are laughing at you. You know why they laugh at you? You know why my customers laugh at you? Because as I said in the video demonstration, if you watched it, it clearly says that the surface does not make the screen. It's a coating embedded in the screen. And the reason why blue was developed was to give people a more of a deeper understanding of the code. Now, if I do this on a black screen or a gray screen or whatever, it's kind of hard for people to understand that. So with the surface being blue, and having to be able to produce the bright, beautiful colors and all that other cool stuff, you know what I mean, contrast and all that stuff without the image becoming blue, everything becoming blue, that gives people a better understanding of the code. So just to take it a little farther, we made a purple projection screen also. So that means you're going to have to make the purple one too. Well, you got your work cut out for you, don't you? Didn't know a purple screen exists. We have one. I told you, we don't show y'all everything. There's stuff that we work on that you don't know about. There's a 17. Did you know that? We don't tell you about it. We've been at 17s. We tell you about this stuff because it's not meant to be told yet. So we gave an ultimatum. Stay in your lane. You mind your own business. You concentrate on your work. But if you don't, I'll have your last one of your cans up in here and display, and they'll go against a 17. And a 17 is far more worse than what you're looking at right now. And right now against this screen, I have an Elite screen, I have the Parallax, I have the Seymour AV1.3, we have a Gray Cinema, and we have a Gray Cinema 5D, and we're actually eating those screens out right now. On a 2% form of technology, and you want to go against a 17. So if I can easily go toe-to-toe with them, and your product would be a cakewalk. But the challenges still stand. Because you had no business challenging the 12 to begin with. So you're going to have to do that demonstration regardless. The lawsuit is still going to happen. But as for us not testing your product anymore, yeah, we'll leave it alone. You mind your own business. That's what you got to do. Stop doing these fake demonstrations of people's products. What did I do to figure out my control of this? Ah, we carried it. You know it's carried. Carry it here, carry it there. Carry it there, carry it here. Let's keep in mind, when he calls himself making a blue, whatever, I'm going to have to do that demonstration right there. Blues, 15s are designed to be under a lot of stress. They can go through a lot of freaking stress. So we don't want that screen in some background area in the dark. No, that area has to be surrounded and windows fully lit. I don't think your apartment even brings in that kind of light. I'm not sure. I mean, rude or anything, but this place I got over here is well lit. That's why I like this place. But you're going to have to do this demonstration right here. Not sitting in the dark. I want to see it in a fully lit environment. But you can't do that. No, you're not doing it. There's my purple projection screen on the wall. While you're at it, you can make the purple too. We look forward to seeing that demonstration too, a purple projection screen. If you can make that one too, please. Because that has the code in it, just like blue. Make sure he understands this, that if you're going to make the blue, you got to make the purple. Thank you. Oh, yeah, you're going to make our stuff, man. You got to make our stuff. We want to see that purple version, too, because that code is in that purple version. And if you said that you can make our product, then you should have no problem making that purple projection screen. See how much light I have in my environment? See how bright it is? That's, I want to see this. The side of your wall, all this should be illuminated with plenty of light. That's what I want to see. So let's see if the screen pulls off everything in purple. Or if it's just the code doing the work. Meanwhile, this is what's going on over here with the new technology we developed. Yeah, if you're gonna try to do a blue, blue's gotta be in a fully lit environment, plenty of light in the environment. We wanna see that. And I also want to see that purple projection screen done too. I know he said bottom line is to mind his own business, but he has to do that one. Come on, he has to do it. I got to see that. If he's going to do a blue, he's got to do a purple. He's got to do it. Got to do a purple. I'm pulling off my tape off my screen. Got to do a purple. Come on, man. Got to do a purple. Watch this. Watch the code read. It's a purple screen. Watch it read blue.
It's going to turn blue in a few minutes. There comes the Chrissy logo popping up. And there's the screen code kicking in. It's blue now. So we went from a purple surface to changing the screen into a solid blue with white backing on the back of it, because that's a code that's reading from the projector. So you can't just take blue paint and make a product. Can't take purple paint and make a product. You have to have that engineered code, which you don't have. So like I said, if you call yourself doing a blue, might do a purple too. I want to see that one. Watch this. See how the screen is now back to purple? Watch this. Boom, there you go. As a matter of fact, I'll give you a challenge on developing our, we'll give you permission to try to develop our purple and blue screen. That's what I want to see. I want to see you take a purple screen and have a blue, pull up a high, bright blues and greens and reds and everything without it becoming all purple. There you go. He figured out how we do it. That's the funny thing about it. See, we knew people would do that. Oh, we could pick blue paint. We could do the same thing. Knock yourself out, buddy. As a matter of fact, don't forget to show off those white levels, too. Show off those bright, beautiful white levels. See what color they come up. And by the way, we'll be waiting for that purple screen. But until then, let's go back here. There's blue over here. Unmatched. It's unmatched. I understand people might be upset, but we're unmatched. Let's talk to it. Here we got a purple projection screen. I'll put that link at the bottom for you to check it out. Purple projection screen. All right, so let's do, put this off. Put it over there. Make sure we got all our three screens up there. Don't be missing. We got a matte made silver. We're going to do the demonstration on. I mean, if you're going to do our demonstrations and say you can make our product, then you should do the purple. Yep. Don't do one of them. Do both of them. So, you have until tomorrow to complete a purple projection screen that can pull up a white snowstorm. Ever heard the term biting off more than you can chew? That's pretty much what you did. All right, this one we have is a Seymour. It's a matinee silver. Yeah, you didn't know it was a, that's the thing about it. People bite off more than they do. They didn't know we had a purple projection screen. Yeah, when we were displaying that color coding technology, we had a purple and a blue screen. So people think it's the surface that makes it the screen. No, it's the coding within the screen that does it. He'll never figure it out because the way I see him, how he makes his products, yeah, no, never figure it out. All right, so what we have against the screen right now is we have, against our technology, we have a Crow's product right here, which is a personal mix. We have the, what do we have? The Cinema Gray right there on the far end. In the middle, we have a Matinee Silver. We have a Seymour 81.3. We have the Parallax. I think it's a 2.0 or 3. It's one of those screens, but it's actually a silver screen. And in the far end, we have a Gray Cinema 5D. There you go. Versus our technology. At 2% done. And keep in mind, my screen is screen is far darker than all of them. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. So that's why I'm giving him an ultimatum. Because the screen's only at 2% and it's already taken on certified screens with no problem. When it maxes out, we get it at around 50%. You don't want to go against this thing again. You really don't. So we're giving you the option of minding your business. But for right now, I'm going to give you a pass, because the reason why I'm giving you a pass is because I want to see you develop that purple screen. And I want to see you take that purple screen and display a 100% white level on it. Same thing with the blue. Blue had to go through the same thing. Run all the tests. Blue went through, I think blue went, that's a 12? Yeah, blue went through all the demonstrations. It had to be taken outside. That screen was going to be launched. So you have to do all the tests. Go out and get all your sample sheets. Put it all against that screen. Do all the tests, all the demonstrations we've done. Pull your projector back 20 feet. Go get an 800, 900. Pull back 20 feet. Do that demonstration. Test against ultra short throw projectors. Projectors of 1500 to 1 contrast. The whole 9 yards. You got to do all those tests. So it's about 20 something tests under blue. So you're going to have to do that. You're going to have to display that screen in a fully lit environment. Just like. I don't want to see any of those windows blocked up. I don't want to see any awnings, no black shades, no fully lit environment. Find that funny. If he ain't putting his screens under this kind of testing, come on, man, you know exactly what the outcome of that's going to be. You don't even put your own stuff under this testing. They're all certified. Well, actually, we got one that's not certified, and that's his. But all the rest of these are all certified. I saved your hundreds. Yeah. That screen on that far end is $5,000 for a 100-inch.
You do the math.
Seymour AB... Matinee Black, that's what the MB stands for. These are Matinee Blacks. I'll get that cleaned up a little bit better. Yeah, that's a Matinee Black right there. You don't have any sample sheets. See, what they do is they pick and choose what sample sheets
are not going to basically make their screen look bad. They're afraid to do demonstrations against all of them because they feel that their screen is not going to be to measure up. On the other hand, I don't care because I have to be able to see how my product is going to stand up. I don't cut corners, none of that nonsense. So as you see me doing this demonstration, this is how he's supposed to be doing his demonstration against his product. If he's not doing his demonstration, it's not worth your money of buying. Let's put this one down here. Boom. Matinee Black, Matinee Silver, Seymour 81.3. That's what we have now landing into my screen. Should I get more? Get that confidence in your work. I can make, like I said, things that I do every day on my screens, it can be considered to be a challenge for him. I can give him this as a challenge right now. See how your screen results, all these screens right here. Everything I do, every day, it's a challenge. Right now, because they don't do any work. Grab something else. Let's grab something else. Yes. What we have. I'm curious, if we take a darker screen, like a Dark Star 9, that's a darker gray screen, how would that compare up to our screen? Let's try that one. Let's see, because right now, we're in the trial and test areas of the technology, so I need to see all of this. Let's try an Elite Dark Star 9. Let's see how that one comes out. Bam! Let me get on that one. What do we got on the Dark Star 9? Look at that. Let's go grab another sample sheet and see what we can get away with. This is amazing. I'm hitting this everything I got. Everything I got in the sample drawer is crushing it. Look at that. Dark Star 9. $3,000 projection screen. Wow. Freaking crazy. This is what I like about testing my technology. Pushing it to the level. Not babying it or holding his hand. Let's get something else. Cush. Yes. Let's go with the big boy right here. Let's go with this one right here. The Parallax. This is that dark gray one. Let's see how it goes against my technology. Can my technology produce a bright enough image? Look at this. Loving it. Sorry if I get excited, but I love to do these. I'm going to fill this whole screen up with everybody's stuff. Now tell me, this technology is not going to get bought out before it actually hits the marketplace. It probably will. All right, let's use this one. Get rid of another one, see what we get. What do we get? Is it better? No, we're blending. Look at this. Blending. We have a Parallax. We have that in the a 0.8. We have, I think, the 3.2 or whatever it is. Out of Elite screens, we have the Gray Cinema. We have the Gray Cinema 5D. We have the Crow's Personal Mix right there. And then over here, we have the Dark Star 9. Over here, we have the Seymour AV 1.3, Seymour Matinee Silver by Seymour AV, and Matinee Black. And you think, not to be rude here, disrespectful, you think your screen paint is going to hold up to this monster? Look at these sample sheets lay against this screen right now. Like I said, mind your business and stay in your lane. All obsolete, everything you have in 1 month. Let's get something else and see what happens if we can knock it out. Right here by Seymour AV is a Matinee Black 0.9 right there. Let's see what this does.
Oh, we ran out of freaking tape. We got more right here.
Now the screen is producing contrast. I love this. 2% done. 2% done. I still got ideas. Right now, from what I'm watching, from the other sample sheets up here, I'm seeing areas in the code I can easily change to make it better. Just by learning off the other screens. Well, not crows, but I'm learning off the other screens. Matinee Black. Let's see what you got. Matinee Black 0.0. Put you there. Let's take the other screen and put it here. We have an even up. So let's see what we got. Boom, 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 boom. Yes. You see that right there? The screen is crushing it. I love it. I freaking love it. Yeah. Mind your business. I'm gonna obsolete you in a month if you don't mind your business. You can see already from the door, all these screens. I love it. My screen's dark. Some of these screens actually come close to a blend with our technology, and it does. So a couple of them do. So we have, let me see which one comes the closest to it. The Darkstar 9 may come the closest. But remarkably, this screen's going to do this. You know what? We're going to sell that 275 court. For what it's doing right now, yeah, it's worth way more than that. Way more than that. I could sell this for $500 a court if I wanted to easily. Because I have the clientele that will buy it. From what it's showing right now already. I just need one of the screen up here to complete it. One more screen up here to complete it. And you know who they are, and they're not going to basically allow us to test the screen. But like I said, I'm going to do it at 260, maybe 255 a quart. That's what we're going to do it at. So you got a screen here that basically, and keep in mind, it's still rear projection technology, which means you can coat this onto plexiglass and make it rear projection. None of these screens have that capability. It is ultra short throw compatible. Some of these screens have that capability. And on top of that, the technology is designed to be weatherproof, which means none of these screens can go outside. Only ours can go because they're designed to be used outside. Look at that. Versus everyone. I got to change this title now. I can't put the question mark down there. I got to put down versus everyone. That is everybody right now inside of my sample drawer. Everybody. Alright, I gotta bring it back. Where the freak is the remote control? Because right now I'm hyped up right now. Exactly what I needed it to do. There we go. Now let's bring it all the way back. I gotta see this. This thing just took on everything. So before we start this, let's see what we got here. We got the Gray Cinema. We have Crow's Mix. Stay in your lane, trust me. We have over here a, what do we got over here right here? We have a Matinee Silver. We got Seymour 81.3. We have the Parallax or Parallel, and I'm butchering that name. What does this one have? This one has a 2.3 gain. It's a 2.3 gain. We have a Gray Cinema 5D. Yep. Over here we have the Parallax. I think it's the Parallax. What's this one right here? This one is the 0.8. Over here we have a Matinee Black. We have a Darkstar 9 with a 0.9 gain. And over here we have a Matinee Black by Seymour AB with a 0.9 gain versus our technology. So let's begin. I love doing these demonstrations. I said, anybody who's doing gray screens, if they're not doing this, if they're picking out the sample sheets they want to use, because they're picking out something that's going to be comfortable with their screen. That's what they're doing. I don't do that. I push my screens. So let's see how it stands up to this night.
And she did quite well.
I got one more company that I want, and I can't get them because we can't get them.
Look at that. Look at that. Yeah. Oh.
And you want to go against this. This is only a 15. It's not even a 17.
Let me look at my snack. Right now, I'm so happy right now. It is not even funny how happy I am right now.
Look, it's matching screens and actually outperforming screens at the same time. This is madness. This is what I'm talking about. By pushing your technology to the next level. Not that baby nonsense.
And those who are offended by that, I'm sorry.
But this is what you're supposed to be seeing. Not only with screen paints, but you should be seeing this with high-end professional projection screens. You should be seeing the same thing. So I spent $5,000 for a projection screen. I'm sure enough you might want to see something different than basically being tested against a white screen, wouldn't you? And this is at 2% done. Do you understand that point? You get that? You understand that 2%? And it's causing this kind of damage already.
God, it's going to be a monster. It's going to be a monster. You should be calling this Frankenstein. Calm down. I don't need any hype up. Calm down. I can't believe this, man. It's freaking amazing. So much. God, it took 2 hours. It took 2 hours to make this stuff. 2 freaking hours. And some of these screens took anywhere from 9 years to 5 years. And this stuff took 2 hours to develop. And you're going to tell me, God, it's not amazing. Look at this. The ideas he gives me. Some of these screens took 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. That technology took 2 hours. Oh, you can be sure basically someone's going to give me an offer for this. Man, that's beautiful. Come on.
We're gonna let that run. That's gotta be run and it's gotta be documented.
Yeah, I'm impressed. That's amazing. That came out freaking. I had certain screens, I was gonna keep it with the light gray screens, and that's what I was gonna do. But some say, you know what, it's not a test if you're gonna have it against all light gray screens. So let's bring out the darker screens. So that's why I started grabbing the Dark Star 9 and that Parallax, or whatever I call that screen. Grabbing all the dark samples, grabbing the light samples, grabbing everything to see exactly how it's all gonna compare to the screen. And it came out way better than I thought it was gonna come out. I'm freaking unbelievably impressed. This is amazing. At 52%, this screen is already handling this weight. When this thing reaches probably 20%, even 30%, it's going to be to hold its weight on a level that no other screen is going to be to come close to it. Should have known that the first time I saw the screen pull that white level. It came up higher than Crow's personal mix. Should have saw that one coming. I gotta find something else. I gotta find sample sheets. I don't care how light they are or how dark they are, we gotta find sample sheets that basically that we could throw against this screen. This is not going to be enough. We got to throw everything at it. Everything at it to see exactly how much punishment it'll be to take him. Or who can take it down. Look how many sample sheets are laying against that screen. Look. Jamie, or whatever you want to call your name, I would strongly suggest on what you're seeing right now, what you're witnessing, if you're able to see this video, I would strongly suggest that after we give you those challenges, once you complete those or fail those, whatever it may be, that you mind your own business. If not, like I said, this stuff right here was strictly designed to obsolete your stuff. But after what I'm seeing, what it's doing here, yeah, we got something here. It's interesting. Very, very interesting. I'll have all your products put up here, and I'll have this screen line up all your sample sheets right across the screen, as all these certifiers are, and we'll wipe every last one of them out. So I'm just saying, mind your own business, stay in your lane, enjoy your customers, whatever you do, and leave it at that. But you do another review against my product, and I'll make sure no one will buy your stuff ever again when I get done with it. So you got your warning. I'll never forget that. Some fellow, when I started working on some technology, and I'm minding my own business, he want to contact me, talking about, oh, you want to challenge my screen? My man, you don't want to go down that road. I will sink your ship before it takes out of the harbor. Leave it be. Mind your own business, make your money, leave me be. And that's what we're explaining to him. Well, I'm still, like I said, at the end of the day, I'm still going to sue you, but still. Mind your own business, make your product. But if these screens are certified, this screen's went through years and years and years and years of testing. And it is. And her product was developed a day ago. Took 1 hour, 1 hour to make it. And is able to go toe-to-toe with these screens. What chance do you think you have? And we got a product that's not even done yet. It's underdeveloped. And you can do this. Underdeveloped. You couldn't even pull it off on these products. The screen paint's right there. I can mix it with it. Keep in mind, your product is right there where my screen just blended your screen. So you get an idea. Just mind your business.
Well, like I said, I'll obsolete it.
Ain't nice here. I don't have to be nice to tell you the truth. Honestly, I really don't owe you anything. I can just come and just take all your products and just basically put it against my screen on every single demonstration and watch your screen wash out. Or basically get blended.
My screen's going to hit at the same time. We got how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 certified screens and one untested screen versus my technology. We got the patent pending. We're working on for the blue. So since you're trying to make that, consider that another lawsuit that you're going to get hit with. Because that one right now is with a patent attorney right now getting the finalized of the paperwork for the patent pending, and you're on YouTube trying to make it. I'm going to enjoy your collection. Video over too. I'm trying to make a blue. I don't think you learn. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that phone call in anyway. I'm going to start sending my friends out to go collect your stuff so we can have it all lined up here on my kitchen table so we can get ready for some demonstrations, because I don't think you're going to take that ultimatum. So I gave him an ultimatum where he mind his own business. I won't do any more testing against this product against this screen. You already see the tone. We got a 10 certified projection screens laying against this screen right now. And you think you can go toe-to-toe with this? This is my field now, which I mean, as and we're still developing black technology, don't get me wrong, but now we're developing technology on all the way around. Which means now that we have a gray screen, and this is a little more different than that black silver. We're in your backyard right now. And like I said, I could easily, by knowing exactly how your product is made between the UV and looking at the personal mix automatically from the door, I can pretty much wipe them all out in one hit, easily. So like I said, I gave you the option to be able to mind your own business and stay in your lane. But if you do another review against us, just in case, we're just going to buy all your stuff and have it here, just in case. Just as a bit of a warning, just to let you know, don't do it. I don't mind doing reviews against my stuff. I really don't care about that. As long as you're fairly up and up and you don't mix anything with our product and you do things by the book. But if you're going to cheat and do sneaky, slimy stuff like that, then your stuff is going to get obsoleted. Because what chance do you think of you're going to actually surpass any one of these screens up here right now? You've never tested your product on half these screens you did fake demonstrations on. I know there's no way in the world you beat the Dark Star 9. There's no way in the world you beat that screen. But if you want, I could buy your product and I could do the test over here. But if you don't want us touching your stuff anymore, like I said, you don't want people reviewing your stuff, then you don't have the right to review anybody else's stuff. That's what it comes down to at the end of the day. But a warning, mind you, that's your personal mix right there that's disappearing into that technology. Do another slimy review, and like I said, I'll have this stuff broadcasted on a level. We're going to have to pay the money for commercials to damage your stuff so bad, nobody will never go near it. And I'll make your product crazy, put it up against the screen, and show you that it blends in with no problem. I'll match it against your own stuff. Because I know what's in it, like I said, we used to make it back in the day. It's black and white paint. Black and white paint! That's what it is! The screen's gonna be good. I think I'm gonna change over and do 120 inch for myself. I want 120 inch of this technology for myself. Anyway, exactly what I'm putting in that too. I'm gonna do 100 inch. I'm gonna convert the gaming screen, the black one upstairs hanging on the wall. I'm gonna convert that into this technology. Or what I could do is move out the entire frame, get rid of that, and get a piece of plexiglass to fit in there just right and do a rear projection screen setup. I'm gonna do a rear projection screen. Care if you hate on the video demonstration, you have to hate on this demonstration. This technology is really good. You got no choice. Bro, your stuff is coming up dark right there. You're coming up really, really dark right there. Very, very dark. Yeah. I'm going to change the title to Versus Everyone. You know, it started off me just doing a question mark. Then I was thinking, like, never really pushed the envelope on the screen. Like, I'm really getting crazy with it. So I'm looking at the sample sheets I have in a drawer. I'm gonna take all my sample sheets and I'm gonna throw them against the screen and see what happens. So we got darker ones, we got lighter ones, we got the Dark Star 9, which is a very dark screen, this Dark Star 9 right there. And let's see what happens. And after seeing this, yeah, if I get a bit of a big hit off of this, I'm sorry, but you gotta admit, look at this. Look at this, look at it. This is freaking amazing. And it took 1 hour to make this.
We can build stair steps off of this technology, which means this technology allows us to be able to upgrade as we go along, which means we can make this far better than what it is right now. You know, it's something interesting too, because we figured out how to heighten the white levels in the code. We can transfer those white levels into that. Crushed. Don't be wrong. Like I said, it's an honor any day to do a demonstration against a high-performance projection screen. But I have to see exactly how we measure up. On top of that, it gives us our price point. So at the end of the day, if I wanted to, I have customers that would give me $800 a quart. You know why? Because I can show them a demonstration of our screen going side to side with a screen that costs $3,000 or $5,000. It means any company that has this coating can spray around their white screens and be the dominant majority of any screen they go against. And it will work on the cheap projectors, the knockoff projectors, ultra short, those outside, and even better is front and rear technology, which means they wouldn't have some kind of special material to make the screen rear projection because it's already embedded in it. Oh, yeah. That's amazing God is. Give you ideas that other people can't say. Now, I'm trying to keep myself humble here. It's hard. It's hard to keep myself humble when you're looking at something that's doing this. I'm trying. But you have to understand, some part of me is like, yeah, in your face! Yeah, you have to understand. Sorry about that, but that's how I feel right now. When we finally get to where we want to be, I'm going to be a force to be reckoned with. Trust me. Now, I'm learning from this code. Everything that I'm seeing right now, happening right now, I'm learning from their information. Watching how the screens react to color, how they react to contrast and white levels and stuff. I'm watching it. I'm seeing all how the technology is flowing, how it's advancing, and how to build and make my technology better. I am so happy. I am so freaking happy. Is your screen in your face? Yeah, it's right there. Yeah. Freaking AVS points. I'm like, oh yeah, your product will never go anywhere. I just figured out something really interesting in code just now. This is amazing. And still, we haven't even built the ultimate screen. The coded technology we have here, embedded with that gain that took the direct hit from the sun. Oh my goodness. Uh-oh, contrast levels. Watch the screen dominate. So now, we're doing a contrast level right now, where our screen's pulling up a high enough black level to be able to compete with some of the screens. That's doing a good job, but it looks kind of weird. It's supposed to be kind of a dark. You can see back on that. So now you see our screen can switch to contrast, pull contrast level, then switch back over to white levels. I'm so happy. And it's funny because the same code is here as in 12s.
Not 100%. The 12s have, as you can see, that I can take his lightest personal mix and put it against a 12, and the 12 will wash it out. I think when we finish the other screen, I think we're gonna call that Project Sleeping Giant. Because when that thing wakes up, man, it's gonna be crazy. There you go. Girl, you gotta pull that off. See that screen sitting in that fully lit environment, all those windows with lights on? That's what you gotta do if you're gonna try to make a blue. That for a minute. Let's go have a look at blue. What is it? Environment, window light. Look at my overhead light. See, this is what I want to explain to Jamie, that this is my overhead light right here. See how bright these are? There's no shade on them or none of that nonsense. Always direct contact with my screen at all times. See the background? Well lit from here to here. All well lit. Good luck.
Alright, y'all enjoy. I'm gonna go back and get myself something to eat. This is just being recorded for basically Jonathan's all right, I'm going to retire for the day. Hope you enjoyed the video demonstration. If you want to start getting our orders shipped out for our customers, sorry we're having a little bit of delays because of the snow, but your orders will be shipped out. I always take care of my customers. I am going to retire. Hope you enjoyed the video demonstration. Thank you all for your time. That's all, and God bless. I'm just really happy because that screen did way better than I thought it did. Thank you for your time, and I got to go.